No, hello, those are the best ones.
Face. I want to fuck you.
What?
What do you mean go easy on Maddie?
What go is, easy on me. Jason's, exactly,
Jason's
Jason.
Production notes are to go easy
exactly.
on you.
Exactly. Go fucking easy
it's
on
not
me.
A bit.
Because I just ate a bunch of fucking Momos and I'm ready to rock.
You ate a hotel?
I ate a bunch of Momos.
That's what they call hotels in the West Coast, my guy.
Momos?
The Momo.
Oh, no.
What's up with...
It's a Tibetan dumpling.
Why do I have to wear... Are we recording for once? Why do
oh
I have
my
to,
God, we're always recording. We've been doing this for 6 months.
And we're never
you
recording.
Fucking
we're
dummy.
Never recording. You're a dummy.
Okay,
I'm
not
smart.
A dummy. I didn't say that.
You called me a dummy. You're the dummy.
No, I said Jason was a dummy.
You're the dumb guy on the show. I'm the smart guy.
Play I'm
your,
not the dumb guy
play,
on the show.
Play your position. Well, I hate
play my position.
I hate these fucking cans.
Well, why do you have them on? You're not on a fucking news radio show.
How can I hear you, shit
like,
face?
We yell at each other for an hour.
I can't hear
I listen
you.
To you yell about nothing for an hour,
I can't
actually.
Hear you.
And then I go to bed.
These things are so washed. They're just like...
Yeah, so why are you fucking using them?
I feel like I'm
why,
just...
Why do you
I'm,
have to use them? Why do you
because
think
I can't
that's
hear
gonna
you.
Make
this
a
is,
good pod?
This is how he rigs it up. You think I like this?
Yes, I think you like it. I think you, for some reason, those headphones make you feel
no,
like you're in control.
No, I want the ear
somehow.
I want the AirPods, but I like this. Like this.
I want the AirPods.
The this
you
is,
mean the Raycons?
I'm trying to the Raycons. The Raycons.
No, they dropped us. They dropped us too. Fuck Raycon. I don't know.
Listen, Raycon.
They can come back. We love
can
Raycon.
I, can
we
I
love
tell you something about
Ray
Raycon?
J.
Raycon is.
Melissa
celebrities
Etheridge.
Like Melissa Etheridge, Snoop Dogg, and Ray J love Raycon. So,
love
if
Raycon,
you think of those three
love.
Pillars of the music and culinary world.
I just gave my sister found my Raycons at my house. She's like, what are these?
They're amazing because we like, still have Raycons. So don't say anything disparaging.
We love Raycons. I know, and I gifted them forward.
I actually.
I have multiple pairs, and I gave a pair to my
no,
sister.
All bullshit aside.
Excited.
All bullshit aside. Not to do an ad read, but I do. We're gonna drop.
Do not give free ad reads to people who dropped us.
No, they didn't drop us.
Oh,
this 8-foot toadstool just gave us the wrong information.
Oh, that. So now you get to name call him?
Yeah, because he fucked up.
He literally looks like a giant stretched out foreskin. His entire, you can see the little weird veins in it. He literally is like a human tube of cock skin.
He's like
that's what he is.
If Slender Man went to Coachella.
Yeah, I don't know who that is, but I think it's great.
You know who Slender Man is?
Why would I?
Whoa. Amber is the color of your energy. Thinking of a master plan. This is my washed mix.
So you think you wish.
Whoa. Thinking of a master plan. Whoa. 1, 2, 3, and 2, the 4. It's the end of the world and we know it. Whoa. Thinking of a master plan.
I think it's the beginning. I think it's going to be so triumphant and so beautiful. And the sun is going to start shining. All of the fires in California are going to be put out, and you know Joe Biden is going to just fall and break his hip and die.
I mean,
and then Kamala.
Can we not? Can we just like before we go into that? I don't even want to
can't get into it.
Let's
yet.
Have some fun first.
Okay.
So last night,
Jason
I've done
called
this.
You.
I've done this twice that I know of in my life, and in the lifespan of a creature we like to call Omar. I hate these fucking things. And
why do you have them on? You can't hear me?
I can't hear you.
Oh, you actually need cans.
Yeah, I love the AirPods
no,
are way better. This
no,
is so
you
dumb.
Wear
it messes
them.
Up my hair.
Just put them on your head then,
no,
you fucking
I like
idiot.
My hair to look nice.
Joe wears them.
Joe Rogan?
Yeah.
No, he doesn't. He just has...
He's asked to come on the pod. We're holding him back.
He has implants.
Like maybe in a season finale.
Yeah, he doesn't have hair. It doesn't matter. So look, I've done this a couple times in my life. This is also your cue, Jason, to at some point in your at your fucking leisure... Get Omar on the table with the green blanket under her. Whenever you have time. I've done this a couple times. I've done this a couple of times in my life where in the middle of the night, I'll be dreaming or have some spastic fucking reaction. And
Jason's standing at the foot of your bed.
No.
Masturbating.
That's fucking horrifying. No. But I'll my legs are tucked in and I'll just shoot out a leg.
Oh.
And connect with Omar's body.
Oh my God.
And launch her.
That's why she's at like 65%. No, she's, it's from the multiple kicks you've given her from your goddamn elephant legs.
Two kicks. Let me say something though. She's very, like, I basically, it's the equivalent of taking a senior citizen and pushing them off like maybe a 12-foot ledge. Not even pushing them, like Spartan, like Sparta. This is Sparta kicking them off a ledge.
This is Sparta. You kick up, yeah, because you're a giant human. Your legs, you're literally. What are you doing, Jason?
He's collecting Omar. Don't look at him. Focus.
Oh my God! You see how he's standing there with his arms behind his back? Like, what is he doing?
A lot of people want Jason. I'm getting a lot of DMs about people wanting Jason. They DM me saying Jason does a bad job, and they say we need him on the podcast. We need to thank you, Jason.
We need answers. We need answers. I need answers. I need answers too, so maybe we should have him on the pod.
Full This Is Sparta kicked Omar off the bed.
When last night.
And and she's fine. Look at her. She's very scrappy for a senior citizen. Nothing broke. She's still good. She's deaf in one eye and blind in one ear. And, you know, she's keeping it moving. You know what I'm saying?
It's when their teeth start falling out. That's when it's bad, right?
Amber is the color of your... Thinking of a master plan. Washed, mixed,
just
mixing
rap with 311.
I'm a 50-year-old DJ just doing blends. Sorry, I'm completely fucking torched right now. I went to bed at 3. I played poker, online poker.
You played poker until 3 a.m. last night.
I played poker all night, yeah. I go to bed at like 10, 11. I know.
That's disgusting.
I know.
You must feel horrible. That would make me feel like an insane... That's like jet lag.
It's jet lag, yeah. I feel jet lagged. I woke up really clogged. And I thought about the podcast because I don't want to be on here snorting. So I took some Zyrtec and some Flonase, and I was going to even... neti pot. You know, I did some vocal warm-ups like red leather, blue leather, purple leather, green leather. Yep.
Bumblebees.
Bumblebee.
I just ate a bunch of spicy beef dumplings and drank a giant coffee. And I drank, and then I had like 5 Advil gel tabs, and I'm fucking ready to rock.
Why did you have 5 Advil gel tabs?
Because I think I had like 3 coffees this morning and no water. And then I just like, you know, when your brain just gets tight. I got tight head.
What
I
is
got
that? Tight. You get 3 coffees in that body. What does that do to your bowels?
It's like if you take a omelet, and then you take an omelet and then you throw a whisk into it and you shake it up in like a bowl, and then all of a sudden there's nothing left in the bowl, but there's just like sporadic egg everywhere.
Just wind and rain.
Except that egg is like poop.
Yeah, I got the analogy, the metaphor, whatever it was.
And it's like whisking
Jason,
a
analogy
fresh...
versus metaphor. Give me a definition. Go ahead.
I think you used the word like, so that would be
what?
A simile, right?
Oh, Jesus Christ. What did he just...
A simile? You fucking idiot.
So you...
Shut up.
You get 3 coffees
Shut
in
up.
You, and you, and the hurricane goes through your
body. I get 3 coffees in me. I get revved up, and I crash hard.
I crash hard
around 11 a.m. Yeah. You know, I've been waking up this daylight savings time. Let me tell you something. I got 3 kids now. You know, God bless them.
God bless them. You love them so much. Smart decision.
I love them so much.
Having
and Trisha,
one,
Trisha,
having one's
we
brilliant.
All love them.
Having one's brilliant. Having
we all
two
love
is
them.
Smart, but having 3 kids is
three?
Like
three is like having
Einstein level genius.
Yeah. it's like that meme of like the
that guy,
cells
yeah,
exploding.
Yeah, you've ascended.
Having three is like you want to rattle your entire existence, rattle it up and have a third child.
Right.
So we're rattled. And, you know, with the sun, so we wake up about 2 hours before the sun even rises. It's like it's rocky. And then Mac just walks in the bedroom like legitimately it's the greatest day of his life. You know, he walks in and he's just like, how are my best friends? How are all my best friends?
Right.
And we're just like, Mac, it's 5 a.m. The sun will rise at 7. You need to go back to bed. The sun, because we try to keep it where if the sun is still sleeping, we're sleeping. You know, that's kind of like our thing. We're like, the sun is still sleeping, Mac.
Are you up with the
sun? Why don't we just go back to bed? Pardon?
Are you up with the sun?
We are up with the sun. Yeah, I'm up. I see the sun rise every day.
Circadian rhythms, man. It's good for you.
It is very, no, it's amazing. I love it. But it is, but 2 hours, 2 hours before the sun comes up, that's like, you need to get the fuck back into bed, you fuck. You can't say that. Bleep that out.
No, you can say. You didn't say.
I don't think you can't say.
Yeah. Yeah.
No. I'm getting that word. So we're just going to bleep all that.
It's a beautiful.
All of this out.
No, we're
editing
not beeping
all of
no,
this out,
no,
Jason.
No, I'm taking a fucking stand. You reference some, which is a that. So,
I think that's great
and great, top notch. What are some
okay,
of the best?
We're editing all of this out, so stop
we're
making
not
it funny.
Editing any of this out, ever.
Yes, we are.
Jason, if you edit this out, things will be broken on people's bodies. Let me ask you something. Speaking of,
listen. So let me finish my story.
Oh,
can I talk
great.
On the podcast
no,
for
great.
Like maybe
yeah, no, let's,
5 minutes?
Let's hear about
I
your
get
son's
5 minutes.
Sleep schedules. I mean, people want to hear this.
Nope.
He's hurt. Look at him. He's sad today.
Nope. I just wanted to talk about my kids, and now you don't care. And I'm sure my fans wanted to hear about it, but, you know, it doesn't matter anymore. So I was going to tell a great story, and it just ends with us making pancakes. So it doesn't really matter. Hey, everybody. Thank you so much. Powerful Truth Angels. Without you guys, we would be nothing. And without our sponsors, we literally would be more of nothing. So thank you guys so much. Continue supporting restaurants and continue to support DoorDash because they are supporting restaurants and people and they're helping stuff. And let's keep the community safe here. And we're, you know, getting the DoorDash apps are really great. And they bring you the food that you love. And that's the thing. When you're at home and you're like, huh, I want to eat cherry pie. No problem. Oh, my goodness. I want a burrito. Yep, we got it. No problem,
DoorDash. You want to talk about America, motherfucker? This is the land where you think it, you dream it, and you have it instantly. If we don't have it within 45 minutes, there's fucking hell to pay. If I can't have a fucking hoagie and some french fries and also a milkshake from Shake Shack and also at the same time, two cheeseburgers, if I can't have that within 45 minutes while I binge watch Gomorrah, I will fucking run into the streets with an unlicensed AR-15 and start and because I need to have it. I need to have my fucking hoagie. I need DoorDash to bring me my hoagie.
We're going
to
bleep
baby.
That out.
What do you mean? No.
DoorDash delivers with contactless. Where you got opposite of what Two Tone said. We got the contactless delivery. And right now, our listeners can get $0 delivery fees on your first order when you download the DoorDash app and enter the code PTA.
PTA is the code. And let me tell you, I need my motherfucking hoagie, man. If I don't get my hoagie and my french fries and my cheeseburgers, someone's going to fucking die. And DoorDash is going to bring it right to my house. They're going to leave it outside. I go outside. I'm in my boxers. I'm wearing boxers, 6 gold chains. I bring my hoagie inside. I turn the TV on. I put that motherfucker in my mouth like what? Like a pencil and a pencil sharpener. Just that's what DoorDash is about. It's America. It's democratic. I need it now. Listen, ordering is easy. Open the DoorDash app. Choose what you want to eat, and your food will be left safely outside your door with new contactless delivery drop-off setting. That means they leave the door by the food, and the food is next to the door, and they walk away. You don't have to even look at the guy. Just go get the beautiful food. Many of your favorite local restaurants are still open for delivery. Just open the DoorDash app and select your favorite local restaurant. Your food will be left at your door. Do you understand what I'm saying? The food will be left at your door. The food will be left at your door. The food is at your door. You go downstairs. It's there. It's fucking magic. It's goddamn magic. Anyways, DoorDash deliveries are now contactless. I said that, but keep it fucking popping with the DoorDash.
Keep
no
it popping. Get the app. Get the app.
It's like a portal. It's a magical portal.
Code me. Code me up. Code yourself up. You get $0. You get $0 delivery fees. $0 delivery fees on the first time. PTA. DoorDash
download
app.
The DoorDash app and enter code PTA. That's 10-0. Right now, our listeners can get $0 delivery fees on your first order when you download the DoorDash app and enter code PTA. A. That's zero delivery fees on your first order when you download the DoorDash app in the App Store and enter the code PTA. Don't forget, that's code PTA for $0 delivery fees. That's zero, the big fucking donut. No money delivery fees on your first order with DoorDash.
We have a really happy life together. And how about that Hypervolt, Two-Tone? Tell us another story. Put that on Omar.
Let's hear the story.
Put that on Omar.
She doesn't like that at all.
Yeah.
I just rearranged her organs. So,
I was trying to podcast like normally and actually talk about something like normal. That's fine.
And though. I was being a dick and saying,
we're going to edit the whole thing out. We're editing out literally. We've been talking for what? 7 minutes? We're going to edit the whole thing out.
We're not editing any of this out. It's fucking golden. This is how we win.
This is how we win. Listen. This is how
let me ask you
something. It.
Serious,
it's Friday night.
Seriously, question. Let's just get back to it. You know, first
sunset.
Of all, are you in a fragile state today?
I'm not.
Okay, because I hit you with just like a little snarky comment and you look totally defeated and derailed.
Well, no, because I was like actually trying to tell it like a maybe like do a I was trying to do what you asked me to do, is like podcast, not just come on here and like scream and be shrill. And I was just trying to talk, and I'm trying to like, you know, be a better podcaster. So I was just talking. I don't really have a lot going on in my life besides being highly successful and being an extremely important family figure. So I was just trying to kind of shine light on parenting and you know how difficult it is sometimes for all the parents listening. But Two-Tone lost interest, derailed the whole situation, and now we're here where, you know, we get to talk about the presidential election that's going really well.
No, hold on. Speaking of family,
we're still not talking about it.
Let's go back to
okay.
Family. Let me ask you something really important about you and your family. How many boom booms do you make a day? How many doo-doos do you make a day?
How many doo-doos do I make a day?
Yeah.
Thank you.
How many boom booms?
Nice. Got a water.
Oh, look who
had
some water. Put some water in the mix, Maddie.
Well, see, the thing is I either have a lot or none. It's either like the tap's on or the tap's off, you know? And so then sometimes it's like, I don't say daily. I like to think of it weekly. You know, I like to like average out weekly.
You're doing 21?
I think weekly,
21 a week?
You know, like yesterday, I don't know. Like yesterday, dude, out of nowhere, I just like shattered. It was like somebody literally took a bucket and like poured it down my face, and like it just shot out my body. It was just like, I sat on the, I was like, oh my, you know, when you get your little tummy, like you feel like, oh, I'm gonna have diarrhea. I was like, I feel like I'm gonna have a little bit of diarrhea. And I sat on the toilet and it wasn't that crazy, but then all of a sudden it was just like, like puddles. Like somebody just kept pouring a bucket out of my asshole, and it was just like this brown. It was like somebody was mopped, like somebody mopped an entire basement that was filled with dirt, and they had like a never-ending bucket of mopped dirt water, and they just were pouring it out of myself. And then I looked into the toilet and it was just like brown foam. It was foaming up, it was oily, it was, you know, I don't know what else.
That's enough.
It smelled like burnt hair.
Yeah, I'm letting you run this thread out. It's great. I mean, I feel.
Yeah,
I feel like
this is gonna be like, this is the swipe up.
I feel like this.
So it was like an oily, frothy,
no,
frappuccino of like just like I'm like I woke up with like dry, like
it's,
you know,
no,
chapped lips because I was so dehydrated.
Listen,
from
I feel
it.
Like I feel like what's going on internally in your stomach is a basic mirror image, a working scale replica of America. And
yes.
And if
yes.
your body is America, then Florida. If Florida was very short and stubby, Florida would be your penis, and
my
your
little peck, my yeah, little pip.
And your ass would be somewhere in the East Coast, and you're shit in the ocean. All the problems of us in America, and you know we're a mess, and your internal organs are probably screaming for help on some level.
My internal organs are great. My CAT scans go well. Speaking about health, you know, your colonoscopy went really well with your cock that had abs.
Did we talk about the
colonoscopy? Your cock that has abs. Yeah. Yeah, so your cock that has a six pack, because the nurse saw her that when she saw your penis.
You're trying to shame me for a shitty bit that you shame me on an episode
ago.
No,
I'm not shaming you. I'm just referencing if people are new to the podcast this week, Alex got a colonoscopy and he went into this really amazing bit about how the nurse was like, oh, doctor. And she called him over. And then Alex had she's like, have you ever seen this before? And his cock.
World and
his cock had abs.
No, it.
So, you know, for all the people out there that have abs on their cock, good for you. I don't. Mine looks like a baby elephant ear or something. There's like three of those, or like orchietti, you know, like a Italian pasta, like three of those kind of like mashed together. Or like a broken leaf. So what were you talking about? What
so
was
in
I
the
talking
morning,
about?
In the morning before the sun comes up, your beautiful child, Mac, he wakes up and he says, Daddy, I want to talk
He's
to you about
like,
our
Daddy,
day.
We're best friends. He always asks if we're best friends. He always asks how strong he looks in the morning. He'll
God,
come
that
in and
is
like
such...
flex and he'll just be like, Daddy. Because for some reason, I told him when he was really young, like, if he goes to bed, you'll wake up stronger.
Yeah.
And so he wakes up, like, every morning, and he just, like, flexes, and he's just like, do I look stronger? And he's like, Daddy, look, I slept, and I look stronger. And he's like, feel my muscles. Feel my muscles. And he's always like, you're the strongest, Daddy. And I'm just like, okay, I'm the strongest. But then I'm, like, telling him now, because now I'm like, don't be that kid that goes to school, and he's telling everybody that his dad's, like, the strongest.
No, be that.
I feel like that's.
No, be that's that
the,
kid.
And then I'm like, but I live in a small town. I'm like, dude, I live with farmers.
You're gonna
There's
have to
a lot
get
of
socked
really
up.
Strong dads. Yeah. There's a lot of trades, guys.
Someone
you know,
pulls
really
up and he goes,
firm.
I hear Mac's been telling my son you're the strongest dad in this town. You're like,
hey, you want some beef?
Yeah.
Just squishes my hand. He's been like bricklaying his entire life. Yeah. He just smushes my hand and like, you know.
He's literally been pulling a wheelbarrow and planting fucking corn by hand. Like,
yeah.
I was talking
for years, his entire life. For,
yeah. Yeah. Just hand is just like a gauntlet. It's just,
yeah.
I mean, listen, I make fun of the, you know, like the whole thing with the kids, and I'm always like, you had another kid that you're never going to sleep. And like, but I feel like the joy of having your son come in and show you his muscles, and like the time in your life when all you really wanted was like some ice cream, your dad, you want to be as big as your dad, and you want to show him you're buff. And
dude, he wants to constantly do competitions just with himself. He'll be like, Daddy, 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 time how long it takes me to jump.
Yeah. That's a good one.
And you're just like, and like last night, he was jumping off the couch onto this. He put all these pillows on the floor, and he was jumping off like the arm of the couch.
What a time.
And literally, I'd be like, 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's how long it would take him to like land. And I did it really slow the first time. And then by the end of it, he kept on doing it. And I'd be like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I'm like, 10 seconds? Yeah. And he's just like, 10 seconds! He's like, Mommy! Mommy! Come inside! Mommy! And it's just like, it's incredible just to watch. He's so stoked on 10. He can stay in the air.
10-second
air
time. 10
seconds.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
He's just like, he's like, look how long I could stay in air. He's like, I'm a superhero.
He's basically
you're
LeBron
just like,
James.
It's an amazing thing.
Yeah.
Everything falls apart. Like everything like falls away, you know, all your stresses. And I'm there just like, you know, counting as fast as I can to make my son feel like he's flying. You know,
and
so
meanwhile,
that's really nice, isn't it? That's really nice.
It's parallel lives. Your son's flying through the air, and I'm launching Omar off the bed in the middle of the night for
you're
no
launching,
reason.
You're kicking I'm your just, beautiful daughter, Omar,
just kicking
off the
shit.
Bed and playing poker till 3 a.m.
Yeah.
Not good for your
I don't do that very often.
Did you win last night at least? Did you
I
or
went,
did you stay because you kept losing?
No, here's what happened.
Okay.
I played in a tournament. I did. I played well, but I lost. The tournaments are like that. Then I played a cash game. I was doing really good, and I made a call that I checked with some friends of mine. It was a good call. Just for anyone that plays poker, I had a pair of queens, and a flush draw, and the highest card on the board was a jack. The guy had a set of jacks, and I lost, and I lost like in that hand. I lost pretty much everything. And I was down to like, you know.
How much was everything? What,
I mean,
how
I was
much
up,
were you
I
in?
Was up to like, you know, 800, 900 bucks, but with $300 buy-in. So I had $500 up. And then I rebought because I was like determined. And I was like, I have to at least get my money back. And I stayed up and I played. And then I left up like 400 bucks. So I got it all back. And then, you know, I got it all back and then some. But
did everybody leave at 3 a.m.? Or did the game keep
going? My girlfriend had a really rough night. And she woke up this morning in agony. I'm just going to say that. I'm sorry, baby. It happens. Usually I'm the one writhing in agony and becoming like...
Well, how late did she stay?
She went to bed at like she got wiped out around two. Like she took the worst beating she's ever taken, I think, in online poker. And usually the thing about
what are you guys just playing on your phones?
Yeah, you play on an app and then you use Venmo to like pay everybody. It's a whole thing.
No. Quote, so you guys are just laying in bed next to each other doing
no,
this?
No. We were playing. Renee came over. We were all playing. Renee is also going through like a horrible time, so he's just crucifying himself by playing poker. And he's just like, we're like, Renee, stop. And he goes, I'm going in. I have King Five. We're like, Renee, don't do it. He's like, I'm going all in. He just kept doing it. He's like, I'm down $1,500. Like, should I rebuy? We're like, don't rebuy. Go home. And like, I gotta tell you, my girlfriend is such a good person because when I eat shit at poker, it's the one part of my life where I become a real piece of shit and I get like cranky and I'm like, just don't talk to me for a minute. Like I get angry and she's like, she's very gracious.
I've seen it. I've beat you. I know what it's like. I know.
You know, well, you beat me in a really crap way. I mean, I had aces, right? In that hand, I had a made hand, and you don't even remember what you had. You don't even know what you were doing, and you just stumbled through and it was you beating me was fine. It was what you did after that was horrible, and you didn't just talk to me about it. You didn't have a discussion. You got up and called me a loser. You said I had no family. You said my heritage was shit. You talked about my genetic makeup. It was horrifying. Anyways, that's enough poker talk. You know, but I'll tell you something, you know, have you seen that movie Gamora? It's the
I'm gonna blow into the microphone with a fried brain and come out with, have you seen the movie Gamora?
Have you seen it?
Yes, I have.
Okay, do you like Gamora?
I've seen all great films.
Okay, that's not true. So you like Gamora. So
Gamora's great.
Okay, here's what I love about Gamora.
Do you like the show? I haven't watched the show.
The show, okay, that's what I was leading into. We can skip that. We'll go right into the show. This is what I love about the fucking show, okay, is in America, we have this idea of American mafia films, right? And it's like they're so rich with like food and like the cars and the homes and so luxurious. Like it's very,
guys are running around in flip flops and scooters, just like murking everybody.
Right. And like, it's like when Paulie Walnuts in Sopranos goes to Italy and he's like, where's the gravy? Where's the marinara? And they're like, you idiot. We eat fucking like octopus and beans. Like we don't eat fucking red sauce and everything. You fucking dumbass. And then when you watch the show, when you watch Gamora and it shows like street level Italian mafia up to like, you know, the Don, it's like the world is so rich because I've never seen anything like it. I've never seen apartments like this. I've never seen Italian projects. Like when you go to the Don's house.
Do you want to go to Sicily?
No. When you go to the Don's house, you look at his place and it's like he's got a TV in front of the dinner table with a crazy Versace thing behind the TV. Like everything is so beyond. It's so gaudy. It's amazing. Like it is. Like it's so good. Like the guy Jenny, are you watching the show, the TV show?
No, I haven't watched
it. You have to watch it. It's fucking, it's like, I don't even know if it's actually good, but I can't stop watching it because it's so good. And like, there's this song, there's this like Italian rap song. It's like, like it's stuck in my fucking head. I want to play it for you, but.
Isn't it based in Sicily?
I think they're in Naples, but.
No.
Yeah. And then in the second season, gets into like one of the Dons is they're in Naples, and one of the Dons is like in love. I don't want to ruin this, but one of the Dons is like in love with a trans person, and like it's really forward in that like there's like these whole things like things you don't usually see in Italian mafia movies, right? And like
American,
yeah. American crime, mafia. Crime, American crime. Well, even American crime movies, you don't see this stuff. And anyways, I love it. I love Gamora. I'm watching the second season. It gets so crazy, and I love that these guys are fucking running around their scooters, and it's fucking sick. I love it. I think it is good. I don't know if it's good. I can't guarantee it's good, but it's good to watch. And I like watching it good, and it's really good. And I love all the Versace prints, the crazy gold leaf everywhere, and the fucking, I don't know. It's fucking awesome. Cool. Anyways, great talking to you guys.
I watched a movie that I didn't like last night.
What'd you watch, my guy?
I watched the History of Ned Kelly. It's on Netflix. It's like a new one. I don't know.
Oh, like I can hear.
It was like too arty. Oh, the producer's typing.
Oh, Ned Kelly, the guy with the iron mask thing on his face.
Yeah, the Australian.
Oh yeah.
But the I watched that last night, and it had the makings of it, but it got too arty.
Right.
It got too arty where right. I feel like the story just kind of fell off, and like I think it's just I think they tried to make it kind of very. It was very kind of similar. I feel to Bronson.
Bronson. Like, oh yeah, I didn't so much. Like, I didn't love Bronson. I love Tom Hardy's amazing, but I didn't love Bronson so much because it was very theatric.
Yeah.
I like more.
Yeah,
of a,
that's
of
what
a,
this was. This turned into like it was like kind of brutal, and it was like everyone was. I felt like everyone was too good looking in it too.
Right.
Like where like they're all like supposed to be like outback fucking psychopaths. Where I was like everyone was too good looking, and it's just like it's those things where I think people just kind of fuck it up by just trying to make it too arty or something, and it's just like. It's like if the story's still weak, you're just making like a video.
So
you know, like that's the biggest thing. Like a lot of people, I think, misconstrue like where they're just making these like mood poems of film rather than, which I guess is just a medium. But I liked it to really have good. I'm way more about a story actually in a movie, I feel.
So the movie review from you is that it's too arty and you're way more about a story actually.
Yeah, that's what I just said.
Okay, I just wanted to recap.
Yeah, that's the review. You could type it up verbatim and make that like and put that on Rotten Apples.
The new poster, Maddie Matheson reviews.
I'm always looking on the internet for things that I shouldn't be looking at. You know,
what are you looking at, Maddie?
I'm always Googling things.
What
don't
are you
be Googling nothing
Googler?
That you shouldn't be Googling.
What are you
Googling?
My little Google
berries. I'm searching. Oh boy.
I'd like to
thank our sponsor, ExpressVPN, for making my life a little bit easier when I'm looking for things on the internet.
When I log into Ask Jeeves and look for Cambodian death camp fuck scenes, I need no one to know where the fuck I'm at. All right. So let's get into the VPN and what the fuck the VPN's about.
I know most of you are probably thinking, why don't you just use incognito mode? Let me tell you something. Incognito mode does not hide your activity. It doesn't matter what mode you use or how many times you clear your browsing history. Your internet service provider can still see every single website you've ever visited. That's so fucked. That's why, even when I'm at home, I never go online without using ExpressVPN.
Do you guys understand what it's saying? It doesn't matter if you get your internet from Verizon or Comcast or if you fucking made it yourself or whatever local ISP offering there is. ISPs in the U.S. can legally sell your information. So what I'm saying to you is that incognito mode is horse shit. And they're watching everything you do. And every little weird place you go, I'm talking to you, you dirty piece of shit. Every little weird place you go on the internet, they're watching and they know and they have a record. Think about it. Don't you want to be anonymous? This is America. We keep secrets.
ExpressVPN also keeps all your information secure by encrypting 100% of your data with most powerful encryption available. Most of the time, I don't even realize I have ExpressVPN on. It runs seamlessly in the background and is so easy to use. All of you have to do is tap one button and you're protected.
And it's available on all your devices. So let's think about this. Across all platforms, across all devices, I log into my search engine. I'm literally looking for some weird, sketchy shit. I'm in the deep fucking weeds. I'm in the ghettos of Riverside looking for just some dirt in an alley. Just some nasty fucking butt butter. Just
I want to smell it. I want to smell it.
You want to smell the gore. Anyways, I got a good buddy, my buddy Taco. He put me on the VPNs. I didn't know what it was. He uses it for all kinds of shit. He watches shit he shouldn't be watching. Think about it. Go to that fucking chat room you're always scared to go to. Nobody will know. Fucking download that rare book. Wink, wink. Anyways, get the VPN. It keeps you anonymous. No one needs to know what the fuck you're doing.
Express yourself. Protect your online activity today with the VPN rated number one by CNET and Wired. Visit my exclusive link, expressvpn.com/PTA, and you can get an extra 3 months. 3 whole months free on a 1-year package. That is ExpressVPN.com/PTA. ExpressVPN.com/PTA to learn more.
Look, as a guy, here's a test to see if you've seen all movies. Have you seen, speaking of Aussie movies, have you seen The Proposition?
I own it.
Really? Who wrote it?
It was written by Nick Cave, you idiot.
Nice, nice. You don't have to call me an
idiot.
What else?
You want to test me on anything else cinematically?
No, let's talk about
Mr. Director?
The proposition. Let's talk about how beautiful that movie is. Because
that movie is amazing. That movie is fire.
That movie,
is
brutal. It's beautiful. It's got the dude from what's the
guy? Pierce.
Guy Pierce is in it.
And it's got that one dude who's like a character actor. He always plays like very stoic, the bad guy up in the mountains.
Yeah,
the
when he has that really weird brother. Like acid trip where he just stays up all night and looks at the stars. It's so fucking beautiful. Such a good movie. Yeah.
I love those. I love that. Like I love. You know, I think it's just like one of those things where it's just like a really young age. Like I think at a really, you know, like 12 years when I first was allowed to like watch movies that wasn't just like G-rated movies. I think like one of the first movies I remember literally watching Gandhi and just being like mesmerized by I didn't know what a biopic was, but like just it seemed like it was like the entire day on Sunday. It seemed like it was like the longest movie. And I think I really liked that, how that made me feel. And so I loved like Dances with Wolves a lot at a young age. And
I
just think that
a river
like,
runs through it. That's your kind of jam.
Oh dude. I watched The River Runs Through it fucking like 3 days ago.
You kept saying that when you came over, you're like, this is why I have this takeaway with you with films is that when we first started the podcast, you're like, every time you come over to my house, you'd say, put on A River Runs Through It. And I'm like, this guy knows one movie. And then you go, you know what? We should watch Willow. And you're obsessed with fucking Willow. And I'm like, so your vocabulary for film is like Willow and A River Runs Through It.
Yeah. Or like I like Terrence Malick films.
Yeah.
You know?
I like some of
those. I just like things that are like very, but the thing about it is like where even like Tree of Life was like just a little too clusterfucky for me. But it's just, I think, you know, I just like, I like really long, drawn out, kind of go nowhere films, but they actually do go somewhere because they actually make you feel a type of way, which is like the thing where it's like, I feel a lot of people try to make you feel a type of way when they should let the shooting actually make you feel that you are a part of it and that it does bring real emotion into you rather than like force it. Right. And that, I think that just comes with maturity from directors and cinematographers and stuff like that.
Did
is
you
this
like,
too much?
Did you like Chopper?
I do like Chopper. I like Chopper better than Bronson.
Yeah, way better. I love. I think
Chopper. But that's like a really great story. That time period's amazing. I love that he was covered in tattoos. I love that he had to go full psycho to fucking get out. Like, I just think it's just like, you know, he was just like, I got to tip over my own pot of tea to get where I need to be.
Can you IMDb Chopper? Because I know that moves into like Animal. I don't know who the director is, but Yeah, and did he do
Animal Kingdom?
Yeah, did he do Animal Kingdom, or is that another one of those Aussies?
The Animal Kingdom on the TV show is bullshit.
No.
That movie's so fucking good.
The movie's so good, and the TV show is bullshit, but let me tell you something. I'll fucking watch it. I watch it.
You'll watch it.
I'll put
it's
it
like,
on at work.
I'll watch Sons of Anarchy every time. Like,
oh, dude.
I'll just
don't even
in.
Listen. When I had an office with Manface and Sons of Anarchy, like I started watching Sons of Anarchy, and it's like one of those things where it's like the same way you look at People magazine in the grocery store or fucking like Us magazine.
No, it's so good.
Yeah, you crack it open, you're like, this is so dumb, but let me see what Selma Hayek's up to. And you're like, oh wow, that's cool. She has a bikini picture, and you just keep, and next thing you know, you're knee deep and just like, I'm deep in the fucking narrative of these guys. And like, I'm like,
yeah, you're reading about Jennifer Aniston's secret lover and like Ryan Reynolds' breakup. But
you know who's great in Sons of Anarchy is the guy that's in Goon. His name is I know you've seen Goon, right? Obviously.
Yeah.
I love Goon. Goon's a really fucking funny movie.
We should get Baruchel on. I bet we could get Baruchel on.
What? Get that guy on? Are you kidding me? He's a
dude.
Git.
He's like
he's your best friend. I know. Like, he's your best friend. Jay. You guys shared a womb together. It's amazing.
No, he is very good friends with Wade, who's like my best friend. So we've become very close. Like we go for like dinners together and all that kind
you
of
and
stuff.
Jay
like,
Baruchel.
Say that
get that guy on. He's fucking great. Tropic Thunder,
Jay's
the
best.
Goon. He's amazing. He's hilarious.
Well, Wade does all the music. Wade did a bunch of music, even for his new horror movie. What's we'll call it? We should have him on actually. The Random Acts of Violence. Wade did all the music for that, and Wade's in it.
I don't know this movie, but
it's a new horror. He did like an actual like fucking horror movie. It looks sick.
Who, Jay Baruchel or?
Jay Baruchel wrote and directed and I believe acted in it. Yeah.
Nice. Very nice.
Yeah.
I'm going to make
it. It's kind of like a Cabin Fever. What did you think of Cabin Fever when it first came out?
I never really got. I wasn't on.
Did
the
you
cabin.
Like the Roth? You didn't like Eli Roth?
I like Eli Roth. I like Hostel. I like both the Hostel movies. I didn't really get into Cabin Fever.
Cabin Fever was such a big movie for me for some reason.
But you know what I loved was Cabin in the Woods. Did you like that one?
Never watched it.
Oh, that's a great fucking movie. You got to watch it. It's really fun. Like, it's a fun horror movie.
That's so nice of you. It's fun. Lisa, can we make a point of me watching Cabin in the Woods, please? Thanks.
Lisa,
really
can you
fun.
Can you schedule Maddie to sit down and watch Cabin in the Woods with his kids? Speaking of, listen, when you talked about watching G-rated movies as a kid, when I was a kid, my mom and my stepfather took
Could you
me,
watch whatever?
They took me to a drive-in, and I watched a double feature of Cat People and American Werewolf in London. And let me tell you something, at that age, I can smell the gore. Like, it imprinted in my brain because Cat People, all I can remember from Cat People is like sex and blood and panthers. That's all I know from that movie. But it's like, I can feel the texture in my head. And also, American Werewolf was so gory. And it's just like, and then my mom, I was so freaked out. My mom goes, okay, well, here's a magical bracelet and it'll protect you. If you take this, it'll protect you from your dreams. And I remember being a kid and being like, you're so full of shit. This is not a magical bracelet. Like, werewolves are real. I'm going to get fucked by a panther, right? But yeah, I should go back and watch Cat People because I don't remember. It's Natasha Kinski.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I remember the first time I ever saw violence on television. Me and my brothers woke up really early and we watched Highlander. And
we've gone down this road before, just a heads up, and I will pile onto this. I don't give a fuck.
Did I talk about this?
We've definitely talked about this. Of course you have. This is the seventh time you said this.
This is not the seventh time I talked about the first time I ever saw Highlander and my parents busted us and we were so scared.
Seven times. This is number seven.
Seven times. Every other podcast
every
we've
other
ever
podcast,
done.
Yeah.
I mentioned the time that I was in grade 3 and I watched.
Yes, we've only done 14 podcasts.
And we got in a lot of trouble.
Yep. No, it's a great story, but I have this.
And my dad killed Conan the bunny in front of us because we did that. He cut the bunny's head off to show us what that really, you know, if you want to watch bad movies, this is what you'll do, and we'll have to kill this bunny in front of you.
You've never mentioned this part of the story.
Because I never did it. You think my dad would do that?
Oh, why did you go with this? Such a good deep cut. Your dad cut the head off.
I was just like,
You like swords and violence,
like, You want to watch this? You want to watch Highlander, do you? Let me show you what the reality... My dad grew up in a slaughterhouse. So he was just like, you want me to show you how to cut a bunny's head off? Because that's what you think that this is nice? This is what you want to watch? You watch Care Bears. You're allowed to watch Care Bears. You're allowed to watch Transformers.
Yeah.
Dude, I never even saw The Simpsons until I was like 13.
Yeah, I told you. I'm going to tell the story again because I love it. But when my stepmother took me to her friend's house one day, and that woman took me and put me in her bedroom and sat me down and just turned on the TV. And I just sat on the edge of the bed. I was a little kid. I was probably like, I don't know, 10-ish something, maybe 11, 12. I don't fucking know. She sits me on the edge of the bed. It's just me in this woman's room. And she puts the TV on and all of a sudden just starts from scratch, Highlander starts. And I'm just a little kid. I have no idea what's happening. I'm just going, okay, I guess I'm just going to look at this.
Dude, that parking lot scene when they're in the parking structure?
Dude.
Like, that's the scariest thing I ever saw.
I think that changed me also. Seeing that film out of the blue with no context at that age, I was just like, this is maybe one of the best days of my entire fucking life. Like,
dude, the bad guy, when he like rapes that woman and like cuts her fucking head off and like, dude, that guy was crazy. That bad guy in it?
He cuts a woman's head off? I don't remember that.
He cuts off that one woman's head.
It's
like
so
I remember
good.
The guy. That guy looks so gnarly in that
the
movie.
Quickening?
The guy. What? Yeah, he's always
and like
dude.
Sean Connery in his prime when he was just like the most handsome, helpful man. Before you saw the video where he talks about slapping women. You see how that video resurfaced?
Yeah, I saw that video. Also, I saw that video. Shame on you, Sean. I didn't post about you dying because I think that was just whatever. Like, James Bond doesn't need me to post. But did you read the... that's a horrible thing. I don't want to even make a joke about it. That's bullshit. But I think fucking the best thing is the letter that he wrote to Steve Jobs. That's like the best thing
What did
ever.
He write to Steve Jobs?
You didn't see that?
I don't know
Dude,
this letter.
It's like a fucking... Maybe he dictated it to somebody. It is a letter from 1998 to Steve Jobs, telling him to stop trying to engage him in being in a computer ad, and that he would never be in a computer ad, and that he is merely a computer salesman, and that he was fucking James Bond. And he told him to fuck off in this letter. And people were posting a bunch of it, like, online. And it's like this letter signed, like, Sean Connery. But it's this letter telling Steve Jobs to fucking fuck off, and that he's just a computer salesman, and that he is fucking James Bond.
Fake. Now, is it? He just destroyed it. It's a fake.
Is it fake? The internet. See, fake. Who knows what's real?
Guys, sex.
Sex.
We all listen.
Let's talk about the big elephant in the room. The big elephant in the room today is always
the big elephant in the room is called fucking. And here's the big secret. Everybody, except for like maybe 0.1% of the world, likes to fuck. And I'm talking from the most beautiful people, from the most unattainable people, to the most horrible, disgusting, gelatinous, decrepit, alien-looking animals
sores,
with frog throats.
Open sore.
Everyone likes fucking. Fucking's a part of life. Sex is healthy. Being healthy is sex. And a healthy life includes a healthy sex life. And if you
and
if
the most
you
important thing
get it up. If you struggle,
well, that was what I was going to say. Everyone's always, is it, does size matter? I don't know if size matters, but I'll tell you one thing. You want to, whatever you got, you want to be, you know, like a mic stand. You want to be at attention.
You want to be rock hard,
at attention.
Baby.
As a father of three, I may not have the biggest, but I'm at attention. Okay. Do I say that? Oh boy.
Listen,
with Roman, you can get a free online evaluation and ongoing care for ED, all from the comfort and privacy of your home. A healthcare professional will work with you to find the best treatment plan. If medication is appropriate, Roman will ship you real medicine with free 2-day shipping.
The whole process is straightforward, simple, and discreet.
It's
the festival. It's the Carnal Festival at Casa de Maddie at the Cassoulet Sex Palace. Okay,
Cassoulet.
All the traditions have been observed. Maddie's been cleaned. His wife's been prepped. They hoist him up in a harness, and they bring him over. Trish. Trish is there. She's surrounded by flowers. She's read her poetry. Yep. She's taken 16 Xanax. She's ready. They lower Maddie down. They lower him down on top. He's floating. Mm-hmm. He's in his great place. He's repeating his sex mantra. He comes down. He's gliding in. Mm. But guess what? His dick isn't hard.
No.
They forgot the one thing. He's got to get hard to refill with Trish mid-flight and pump the fluid into her womb to create another Matheson. He's got to get hard. And you think he's going to get hard after eating 16 pounds of dumplings and 14 Diet Cokes? No. He needs a pill to get hard.
Drink Diet Coke.
He needs a pill. We all need a pill.
Erectile dysfunction used to be tough talk, but now there's Roman. Complete an online visit today to connect with a doctor and take care of it. Your dong loves you.
You're not fucking without a pill. What are you, an idiot?
What are you, in shape and mentally sound?
Yeah, what? You don't have a pill to get your dick hard? Personally, I'm going to use these. I'm going to get some of these pills. I would like a Roman test pack. I want to try them out. I want to see if I can get rock hard and just balance a marble on the tip of my dick. That's how hard I want to be.
That's all. I want to balance you.
You want to balance me on your boner.
I want you to be able to hold on to me.
Let's have a weight. Let's take Roman and have a contest to see how much weight we can put on our boners.
Yeah. I want to see.
I think I can get. Oh,
do you think
no,
you could hold up the Holy Bible?
A book?
Yeah,
maybe at the base.
If you opened it, use it.
Oh, you mean lay it on top?
Lay it on top.
It's not going to be easy, but I think I could do it.
Do you think it would just be like, oh?
It's like the arm wrestling match. Let's get these dick pills in our body.
Let's get a
Roman.
Dick pill. Dick pills are great for you, and Roman is our obviously favorite
Roman.
One. Just go.
I'm doing
go get roman.com/PTA to get $15 off your first order of ED treatment, a free online visit, a free 2-day shipping. Come on!
Let's get these boner pills in our body, Roman. Let's get these dick pills in our body, Roman. Let's please our partners with a rock hard cock. Let's rock their socks, because we're making those Glocks shoot cum out of our dicks, because we're Roman pricks, and we're Roman. Roman, and we're Roman.
Roman.
Roman.com/PTA. Roman.com/PTA. That's getroman.com/PTA for $15 your first order of ED treatment. Get your dick hard and get your life great. Suck it.
Is the election real? Is there an actual election going on?
Well, you know.
When this comes out, there's going to be a president. That's what's amazing.
Well, we'll see. I don't know. I mean, I went into
or not,
this.
Maybe not. Maybe not.
Maybe it's just, you know, I went into this and a couple of days before the election, I kind of just had this thing where I looked at everything around me and I was like, oh, Trump's going to win. I was like, this is just too crazy. Like he's weaponized these motherfuckers to where they're just like, they're pulling people over and hemming them up in the parking lot, surrounding them with Trump trucks. And like, they're just crazy, like methed out fucking white trash psychos. Just like, trying to fight like young women. And I called a couple of people. I talked to my brother. I talked to a guy, a buddy of mine I work with. And I talked to some people.
I talked to a guy.
I talked to some guys. I talked to some people
most important election ever. You're like, I called my brother. I talked to a guy.
Who the fuck am I going to call? Fucking Bernie Sanders? I called people whose opinions I respected.
I don't know. You called the guy.
I called people I respected. And we all agreed that Trump was going to win. So I went into the election. And I went to the election thinking,
and
fuck
you voted
it.
For Kanye.
Fuck it. No, I said, I did my voting. I voted for who I voted for. We know who I voted for. And I went into the election. I said,
Kanye.
I voted for Kanye. And I went to the election. I was like, okay, well, Trump's going to win. And this is I'm just going to deal with this reality and figure out how to live my life with another 4 years of this shit. And maybe another 30 years because the Trump dying, he'll just start bringing his kids in. Dictatorship.
Yeah, dude.
I wasn't plugged. Like when he won the first time, we were all in the office at Born and Raised, and we're all in there and we're like, yeah, this is ridiculous. He's not going to win. No one took it seriously. And then he started winning and everyone's like, what's going on? And we're all watching it happen live all in the office. And I remember when he won, we were just like, everyone was just so crushed. Like we were fucking shook and terrified. And like, we're like, what the fuck's going on? Like it was a horrible thing. And I'm like, I can't do that again. Cause I was fucked up for like a week longer. I was like, I can't have that.
Yeah, we've been fucked up for 4 years.
Yeah. Yeah, I've been fucked up for a week, maybe 4 years. And I was like, I can't have that experience again where I'm like depressed. I mean, I just didn't want to. So I was like, fuck it. He's going to win. I'm not going to watch it. I'm just going to start preparing for that. And then he hasn't won, and Biden seems to be winning. But who the fuck knows what's going to happen? This is like, you know.
Dude, it's crazy town. Russia.
The TV novella called America. Oh, are you kidding me? Russia and China are just like fucking just sharing a hookah right now, laughing.
They're just loving it.
They're at the hookah bar and they're just like,
they're like, do you watch them all? Do you watch all of them? Are you watching America? Fucking losers.
It's fucked up, man. And like, you know,
it's crazy town.
I'm so crushed by what's happened on this country that like the idea of there's two things that happen. One is, if Biden does win, I'll be really happy, and then I'll quickly turn from being really happy that, like,
you have so much more work to do that you're able to kind of do. Where Trump, you would have just felt helpless, but knowing you have to do a lot more work.
Right.
But I think with Biden winning, it's like the second that Biden wins, now everyone needs to just
attack
keep
Biden,
voting, going to primary. Yeah. Like
yeah,
now
attack,
it's just like
attack.
But
his
that's the
bullshit.
Thing. It's just
yeah,
like
yeah.
the thing that I honestly think that is amazing. Is the amount of the like the black votes and like all these people posting about like even Detroit voting for Biden. It's just like the thing that's amazing is that right now, I think the thing that is the silver lining in this is seeing actually the power of the vote and seeing how many extra million people or however many extra people are actually voting, and that they're going to be able to see that they will be able to make some change. And this is just, it takes decades, unfortunately, to change fucking hundreds of years, right? And I think it's like this could be such a moment that Trump could be maybe the climax of the
right.
horribleness.
Right.
That's what I'm hoping. Like, Trump is the apex of, like, this type of world. And hopefully this can be the beginning of, like, us. And not even, I'm not even a fucking American, but I'm just a human. But the way that it makes me feel is that it just, I feel, I don't know what I'm saying anymore. If Trump won, well, once again, this could be the beginning of just a real revolution. Take it the other way, where people are still going to see the amount of numbers that they got close. And if Trump does become the fucking president again, some real shit's really going to fucking pop off.
Yeah.
But it's still like legitimately shit's going to get wild. But it is a thing that I think is the silver lining is the power of the people. Is actually the thing that I'm taking away from this.
Yeah.
And that the people, it even if they matter. Didn't win, everyone showed up. Your vote fucking does matter.
It does matter.
You need to fucking vote. Well, and you need to get every motherfucker to vote.
People that say, I don't vote, I don't believe in it. It's like, well, what else are you going to do? There's nothing else to do. This is our option. You either vote
then,
or don't
then
vote.
Then you're a nihilist. You're a nihilist. Yeah. And you can, if you don't vote, you can have no opinion on anything.
Well, no, they're like, it's all
because
rigged,
your government the government affects everybody somehow.
Of course it's all fucked up.
On some level.
Yeah, no, it's all fucked up.
You can't
it is
say
all rigged,
it doesn't
but
matter.
You have to vote. You have to
Dude,
vote.
It's
you have
crazy
to too. Listen. Listen. Let's say it is all rigged. Sure, and it is. Everyone's fucking around. There's gerrymandering. There's suppression. There's all these things going on. There's a lot of shit that's fucked up. But if
gerrymandering
you don't,
is such a great. It's so great.
It's not great, and the thing is,
it's
though,
not
if
great,
you don't,
but it's a great like word. It's great that it's come back. It's like a full thing. Like everyone knows what gerrymandering is.
Okay, I can't even fucking. Can I finish anything? Today
I just tried to finish something
and I just was talking about if you don't vote right you didn't try to finish something. I started saying a sentence and I was on a thing and you jump into the sentence go gerrymandering is a great word. I'm in the middle of like a fucking whole tangent and you go the word gerrymandering is great. It's like totally left field, like someone just a word just wandered in your fucking periphery and you jump on that.
It's
you don't
like
even
it's
let
a nice
finish.
Word gerrymandering is nice word.
Gerrymandering. Isn't gerrymandering sound like scary handling? anyways, fucking vote or shut the fuck up. I don't know. Either way, it's fucked. Look, I told
you. Either
way,
you can't say shit if you don't, bruh.
We talked about this whole thing where, you know, when we first started potting and this was all happening, I told you I went to this dinner and there was a woman there. Who had been in, she's like, has anyone at this table been in the Situation Room? And everyone at the table's like, no. She's like, I've been in it. Like, she's in the fucking White House. And she goes, I want Trump to win. And I'm like, what? Why? And she's like, because then there will be a revolution. And I'm like, so you're down to just like, because I'm just like, I'm still just like, I would like to be comfortable and get a fucking place to live and have a fucking sauna. And like, I want creature comforts.
Yeah, I have a sauna and a smoothie.
Yeah, I want a smoothie.
You want the comfortability.
I'm like, so you're down to just like get a rifle and eat beans for 6 months and shoot people? She's like, yes. And I'm like, I get it. I understand that. I don't want to go there. But you know what? We might because nothing happens without fucking a lot of eggs getting broken. And if Trump does win... You know, like look, man. The he's galvanized and weaponized. He has radicalized the idiots, and our country is chock full of morons.
Chock.
We are a stupid, rich, fat country of babies who don't value anything but like giant butts and Lamborghinis. I mean, that's we're fucked. You know, like
They're fixated on something that doesn't even exist.
It doesn't
exist. Which is freedom. Freedom. And it's just like,
freedom. There's no like, fucking freedom.
I don't understand what they're talking about.
I mean, there is, though.
You can't even go down and get a loan. Like, what do you guys, it's so fucked. Like, it's just, I don't understand what these people, they're so.
I mean, comparable to other places, like we also too, like Americans, you know, we talk about this, like we're all Americans are up in arms about this horrible year we're having. Right. And you're like, dude, there's places right now where there's just straight up like in genocide. Like there's people just getting slaughtered. People are starving. People are eating fucking turds. And we're like, you know, we had to stay inside. You know, it's just like fucking just. I know it sucks, but
dude,
it's...
I even catch myself doing it where I'm just like, I have to constantly be like, yo, man, it's not that. Like the other day I left, I literally couldn't get food and it was like 9 o'clock at night and I was just driving around and I ended up eating two taquitos from 7-Eleven.
Oh my God.
because no restaurants are open. It's just like crazy. But you're like driving around a city. And, like, I literally can't just go into a restaurant. Like, I'm like, literally restaurants don't exist. And I went and ate two taquitos in my truck and it smelled, and I threw out half of the last one and I was just, I got really sad.
Yeah, I mean, it's a horrible existence you're living. I mean, you had to eat two taquitos and, you know, there's people who have
covered
had,
in nacho
never,
cheese
who've
and
never
like
even
chili.
Seen a taquito. There's people that literally just eat dry beans and
I know,
dust,
exactly.
You know?
Yeah.
But, you know, whatever. I mean, fuck it. You know, it's like, I don't know. Like, I've had this conversation. I was talking to I was on this guy's podcast. It's called
Excuse me?
I was on some guy's podcast. He asked me to be on his podcast.
Someone asked you to be on a podcast?
Yeah, I'll put his link there. It's the Gizmo. I'll show you. I don't have it. I didn't sleep. But
De Gizmo?
I don't
his
know.
His name's De Gizmo?
I don't want to misspeak his name. I'm going to have Jason put it here in my hand. It's a, you know, he's
you don't know the guy's name and you did his podcast?
I know his name. I just listen.
Oh. Yeah, okay.
But anyways, look, yeah. I think that the job of running a country and a nation because of what human beings are is a horrible, disgusting job. And I think as soon as you take the job, you're instantly a murderer. And that's kind of goes with the, like, there is no utopia. There never will be. And we're fucking,
no,
we're predatory
Obama
animals.
Can throw
we're going to continue to
shots,
murder each other and
still
fuck
air striking everybody,
just talking over each other.
You know?
And that's what we do.
God bless America.
Land of the free. Stand beside her and guide her. And you will find. You know what's crazy? I think about this all the time. Like, I'm so old that I lived in a time where they did teach us patriotic songs in school. Like, "Over the Ramparts We Watched." You did too? Which is pretty weird because you
think
we're not
that. I think they still teach that in school. That's like full propaganda shit.
Right. You think we're not that kind of a country, but we're totally are because like the history books are full of shit. Like they just leave out like
history
huge
books
chunks.
Are just incredible. There is like the Tea Party.
He just keeps
Get
talking
it.
Over me. It's crazy. I can't even.
Are
talk.
We political?
I'm going
to. This is a political film podcast today. Brought to you by Hypervolt. Did you freeze or are you just staring at me madly? You're frozen.
No, I wasn't. I was pretending to be frozen.
Were you pretending?
Yeah.
Were you? No, you were frozen.
Gotcha.
Okay. Idiot.
You're a fucking idiot. And people
I'm
listen
not a
to
fucking
the,
idiot.
Yes, you are
I
an idiot.
I know everything. Do you want me to let you sign in
stupid.
So you can actually look at the analytics
you're
of this podcast?
You're a fucking idiot. You have
You're a
stupid Devo.
Idiot.
Don't call me a fucking idiot unless you want to be called a fucking idiot.
I didn't call
idiot.
You a fucking idiot.
Yes, you did, you fucking idiot.
You're a fucking idiot.
You're
not
fucking,
fucking
idiot.
Smart.
You're stupid
You're
as
not
shit.
Fucking smart.
You have a wool Devo hat.
You're fucking
You're
dumb.
You're a fucking idiot.
You're fucking
You're an idiot.
So fucking dumb.
You're
it makes
stupid.
Me sick. It makes
You're
me want to
stupid.
Shit my pants
You're
and
stupid.
Eat it because I'm
You're
so
stupid.
Mad at you for being
You're
so
dumb.
Incredibly
You don't even know you're
dumb.
Stupid, you dumb
you
shit.
You idiot.
You fucking nimrod.
Dumb fuck.
You nincompoop. You fucking dunce cap on fucking ice.
You are fucking literally underwear that have been soaking in fucking diarrhea for a month, and you suck it up and you taste it, and that's how you look.
That doesn't make me dumb. You're not attacking my looks. I look wonderful. I'm brilliant.
You look beautiful.
And I have a good soul.
I love you so much. You're going to have to bleep all that out. You're going to run that, Jason, but you're going to bleep all that out because that's not nice.
No, we didn't say anything bad. No. Let us stay that the idiot thing was good. That's a good bit. The fuck that. Don't bleep it out.